Well, the guy you're about to meet won't mind us suggesting he's a little mad. The truth is, he actually loves that description. Why else would he drive head-on into the most powerful and potentially deadly weather known to man? A short time ago, Sean Casey spoke with Danny Isdale about his new film, Tornado Valley. Ellie.
It's like Christmas out there for me, you know? Every day, you know, Santa Claus is coming.
Now, what is it about you that makes you run towards something everybody else is running away from?
Well, I fell in love with tornadoes, and I wanted to capture them, you know, with an IMAX camera to do an IMAX film. The images that you collect, you know, there's such resolution, there's such beauty to them, that the experience is, of course, almost as good as actually being there.
The IMAX cameras are different to normal cameras, aren't they? They're not the best in one-take situations.
No, the camera that we use, the IMAX camera, weighs 92 pounds. So, you know, it's this very large, cumbersome camera that the film goes through it in 2 minutes and 50 seconds, and then you have to reload.
Where did this passion of yours come from? I understand your dad's a bit of an IMAX legend. Did he show you the ropes?
Yeah, my father was an IMAX filmmaker. And then, yeah, when he would go on these film trips, you know, I joined him when I was old enough to be, you know, somebody that could contribute.
Did you have to carry the light cases
and all
that?
I started way on the bottom. Yeah, my first job was, yeah, carrying cases, you know? But I got darn good at carrying those cases.
Look, it's directly behind us. It's coming up on the road.
Three down. How hard is it to get yourself in the path of a twister and to capture it on film?
It's one thing to film a tornado, you know, from 2-3 miles away. I mean, that's relatively easy. It's a whole different thing to actually try and put yourself right in the path of a tornado, to be that exact, and to actually film a tornado, you know, as it comes directly at you and impacts you. It's extraordinarily difficult. And I spent eight years trying to get that shot of a tornado coming right at you and hitting you.
And how did it feel in that moment?
Well, at the moment, I was kind of terrified. You know, because here you are, you know, we have this homemade tank that I built, and we're, you know, of course, the plan is to get hit by a tornado and film it.
How tough is that tank? How safe is it?
Well, you know, safety is a relative term, of course. I think the tank that we chase tornadoes in is safe, but of course, there's always that, you know, chance where you encounter a strong tornado, a tornado that intensifies right in front of you and could strip you off the ground, or could pick up a large object like a tree or another vehicle, and then all of a sudden that becomes an airborne projectile that slams into you. And so, you know, there's always a risk.
Is it important, not just out of an entertainment perspective, but also awareness, do you think? You spent a lot of time focusing on the scientists that map these monsters. What was the impression you got of the work they do?
They were doing this project called Vortex 2, and it was the largest scientific study ever fielded to study tornadoes. They have 11 radar trucks out there. They have probe teams. You know, the science that they're doing, or what they did, that we cover in this film, is pretty much the premier study that we'll have for the next, say, 10, 15 years.
If you are an adrenaline addict, I mean, how much is enough? Are you ever going to stop? Is this the only disaster that you're going to keep chasing?
There's something so compelling about them for me. There's something so otherworldly about them that, you know, I can't imagine doing any other project than chasing these tornadoes now.
Wonder what he does for fun.